evening, everyone. This is the coolest place I found in town today. We'd like to accept our apologies, and we run into a few difficulties. So, this evening, first of all, we're going to have the Rotary Club Citizen of the Year Award. And then we're going to have a couple songs by Vicki and Valerie Bonsall. And then from there, we'll turn the service over to Reverend James E. Gillum, and pastor of the Curwensville United Methodist Church. And I think his speaker, or one of the speakers of this evening, we have Reverend Earl Brooks from the Presbyterian Church at Clearfield. But I'll let them pretty well take the program as far as that goes, because we ran into a few difficulties and had to make a few last minute preparations here. So, as far as the Curwensville Days Committee, again, we'd like to welcome you in the opening of another Curwensville Day celebration. And my personal thanks I would like to give to those who are taking part in getting everything underway. And hope in the following week that things will run along smoothly. So that's all I have to say myself. So I'm now going to turn the program over to George Jacobs, who will have a presentation of the Rotary Club's Curwensville Citizen of the Year Award. Thank you.
Thank you. It's my pleasure to help kick off the beginning of the Curwensville Day celebration for 1987 by presenting the Rotary Club Citizen of the Year Award. The recipient of this year's Citizen of the Year Award has been involved in charitable and community services for nearly 40 years. A review of his work includes such things as the American Cancer Society, participating in cancer dressings back as far as 1947, Board of Directors from the years 1964 through 1985, Public Relations Chairman for the chapter, Volunteer of the Year in 1987, worked on the Residential Campaign, Daffodil Days, and the Radiothon. Involved in the BFW Auxiliary, Charter Member, again in 1947, past President, Treasurer of the organization for over 25 years, helped with the organization and presentation of a memorial to all veterans, works with the Memorial Day wreath, the Easter egg hunts, and fundraising dinners to help all veterans. A member of Curwensville Presbyterian Church, a member there since 1952, a Sunday school teacher there, secretary for the Sunday school, director of the Vacation Bible School, co-chairman of Women's Society Bazaar, and deacon of the church. Involved with the Girl Scouts for over 20 years, has been a troop leader, a Curwensville unit director, and a day camp director. Involved with the Curwensville Historical Society since its inception in 1977, serves as treasurer of that organization, and organized the booth at the Curwensville Days for the Historical Society, and has worked it for the past 7 years along with her husband. Very much involved with the Curwensville Nursing Home, helps with bingo, crafts, the open houses, picnics, and other functions for the residents up there, and has over 750 hours of volunteer service at the home. Last but not least, is involved with the Curwensville Days Committee. Was vice president in the year 1984-85, and was president in the years 1985-86. It's my pleasure to announce at this time this year's recipient of the Citizen of the Year Award, Irene Rischel.
Thank Congratulations, Irene.
If I may, read the plaque. Presented to Irene Rischel for outstanding achievement and civic responsibility, presented by the Curwensville Rotary Club, 1987.
Guess you have to live a long time to do all those things. And I didn't think I did. But I can thank my God for giving me the help, the desire to want to help others. And my family, Sam, my girls, and all my beautiful friends in this town, John, and I just hope I can continue many years.
We'll be singing a Cole Porter song, You Do Something to Me, and our piano player is Rachel Barr.
Today is July the 12th, 1987. This is Sunday night, the beginning of the Curwensville Days celebration. Before us, we have Mr. George Jacobs, who is the president of the local Rotary Club, and with him is Mrs. Irene Rischel, who has just been awarded the Citizen of the Year. And Mr. Jacobs will now read to us the plaque that was presented to her.
Presented to Irene Rischel for outstanding achievement and civic responsibility. Presented by the Curwensville Rotary Club, 1987. Congratulations, Irene.
It's priceless.
Earl was the
number one choice of the ministerium to bring the devotions this evening. It's special to me for many reasons, because I have known Earl for many, many years. In fact, I had the privilege, way back in 1952, of introducing Earl's lovely wife, Betty, to him, many years ago. And I love them, and it's a real joy to have the Reverend Mr. Earl Brooks, pastor of the Presbyterian Church in Clearfield, as our vesper speaker. Earl, God bless you.
I find my mind, where's our microphone? Jim never needed a mic.
He isn't saying I have a big mouth.
I didn't say that. Is it on? Yes.
Yes.
I find my mind moving in quite a variety of ways as I share with you this evening. I'm truly humbled when I hear the recitation and recognize that it's only some of the things that Irene Rischel has done in terms of service to other people in the name of Christ. Truly humbled by that. Blessed by the beautiful voices of our two young ladies and their songs for us. Thrilled with the choir. Just, that's magnificent. I could have forgotten the speaking part and just had them sing the rest of the evening, and I know you could too. And as Jim said, our association goes back about 35 years. He did indeed introduce me to the girl who for 33 of those 35 years has been my wife. And it brought back a lot of memories to hear Jim Deed singing tonight, because Betty and I were in our teens when he came as the assistant to the pastor of my church in Baltimore, and his voice sounds now like it did then. He looks a little older. But I just find myself moving in a whole variety of ways. They told me not to go over an hour, since this wasn't an all-day meeting with dinner on the ground. And I won't, because I hate preaching to empty pews. So I'd like to begin by reading scripture from John, the 8th chapter. Jesus is the speaker, and he is talking to the Jews. And he says, to the Jews who had believed him. So he's talking to those who responded to his message. He's talking to Jewish persons who had become Christians. And he said to them, if you hold to my teaching, you are really my disciples. And then you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. And they answered him, we are Abraham's descendants and have never been slaves of anyone. How can you say that we shall be set free? And Jesus replied, I tell you the truth. Everyone who sins is a slave to sin. Now, a slave has no permanent place in the family, but a son belongs to it forever. So if the Son sets you free, you will be free indeed.
Vesper services are now over at the Curwensville Area High School.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
us.
Yeah, especially after that, yeah.
And as muggy as it is.
Yeah.
Passing up for probably.
It's a little greasy around.
Nice, yeah. Oh, nice out now.
Oh, it's nice breeze now. Oh, well, now you can go.
Hi.
Hey,
uh-oh.
Bye-bye. Oh, look at Jack Ziff there.
Hi. No, that's not a perform. Get out here.
I may as well get in this too, even though I'm not in Curwensville.
Margaret, you're... Bye.
Wow. Whoa.
Let's get back to the business. I'm working on it.
My fault is Margaret.
Hi, Jack.
How
you doing?
Sam Mitchell, husband of Irene, who just received the award this evening. This is Monday, July the 13th. You're looking at some of the contestants for the King and Queen contest. It's been raining pretty hard here for about the last half hour. Hopefully it will hold off for us long enough to see them be crowned.
We'd like to invite you or welcome you to the first night of Curwensville Days. We had the best for services last night. This is our first night at the park. This evening, hopefully, if it doesn't rain again, we're going to start out with the crowning of the Junior King and Queen for Curwensville Days. This will follow with a small concert by the Curwensville Marching Bands, who are coming right now. And then we'll have a puppet show, and at the end of the evening, we're going to have a dance, if it doesn't rain, by a combination. It's a lake show. Mayor Wainwright's going to help me with the crowning of the kings and queens. We'll announce their names and they'll step forward. And any pictures you want to take, fine. If you want to walk up, that's fine. And then Bobby will read the names off. Okay, thanks.
First, we'd like to announce the junior court representative. Kindergarten is Whitney Johnson, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. John Johnson, and Corey Cathcart, son of Mr. and Mrs. Randy Cathcart. And Matt Richards, son of Mr. and Mrs. Ed Richards, who couldn't be here tonight. third grade is Beth Vokes, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Boyd Vokes. She's not here tonight either. And Michael Morrison, son of Mr. and Mrs. Doug Morrison. Fourth grade is Kelly Bressler, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Alan Bressler, and Jeff Hoover, son of Mr. and Mrs. Jeff Hoover. John Bunnell, and John Anderson, son of Mr. and Mrs. Jack Anderson. This year's junior queen is Shannon Rolls, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Lewis Rolls. And the junior king is Paul Fluke, son of Mr. and Mrs. Jeff Fluke. Would the junior corps please come back out onto the floor? So they can take a picture. Could we have a round of applause for the junior corps and senior queen? Okay, thank you. Now we have the senior corps. Seventh grade, Tracy Schaefer, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Donnie Schaefer, and Chris Fleming, son of Mr. and Mrs. Jim Fleming. Mr. and Mrs. Rex Bauman, and Jason Best, son of Mr. and Mrs. John Best. Okay, ninth grade is Beth Hoyle, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Sam Hoyle, and Matt Bressler, son of Mr. and Mrs. Scott Bressler.
When? It's Meredith's turn. Just when?
Okay. When you get your flowers, would you please stay out here so that they can take pictures? Everyone, thank you. 10th grade is Amy Ammerman, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Dave Ammerman, and Eric Johnson, son of Mr. and Mrs. Norman Johnson, and Eric couldn't be here tonight. Neither one of them could be here? Okay. 11th grade is Jill Gorley, daughter of Mrs. Judy Shaw, and Casey Lezer, son of Mrs. Betsy Lezer. Thank you. queen is Susan Holland, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Dave Holland. And the senior king is John Johnson, son of Mr. and Mrs. Tom Johnson.